Oh, no. Oh.
Rita!
Please listen. Please, God. Make Miss Ferguson help me.
Please, will you stop this protection racket? Kath, it isn't you, and in the long run, you're not going to achieve anything.
That's for me to decide. I could certainly have done with some protection when I first came in here.
Ferguson? Why did you do it?
I don't know.
We'll be around the bend in the jiff. Give him a blast on the hooter.
We supposed to do pin her down, and besides, we didn't know it was the middle of nowhere.
She did have food and water.
Yeah, a mixed shade of the map,
I think.
I see. You didn't know where you were, but Mick showed her the map. Take them to solitary, Mrs. Morris, and you'll stay there until Miss Ferguson is found, dead or alive.
Joan Ferguson's not really dead, is she?
Look, I don't know for sure, but Rick didn't do it.
How do you know that?
Because she told me.
Doesn't prove a thing.
Look, you creep!
Why isn't Roach with them?
I don't know, but she's all right. Let's get away from this scum. I need some fresh air.
The feeling's mutual.
Kath?
What'll I do to Rita if she did it?
I'll leave her in solitary.
How come Laurie said she'd be real crooked on us when she gets out?
We'll just have to make sure she doesn't get out. Then the prison's ours.
Bloody Ferguson! I knew she'd screw it up.
If she does, we're done for. Well, they reckon we've done it for sure.
It could look terribly bad for us.
Not if they don't find a body. No corpse, no case.
No, it won't be as simple as that. I'm sure we'll have to answer for something. If not for Ferguson, then
what can they prove? Nothing. A big zero. Okay, so we gave them a couple of different stories. Well, let's give them a few more, and pretty soon they won't know where they're.
Quiet!
Attaboy, Rodney.
Always.
Hey, you know, it's him.
I can smell him. Who else would be sneaking around like that?
Get rid of one.
Temper, temper.
For a few lousy fags, you stay in one piece. Well, for a week anyway. Pay up time. Get your guaranteed week of protection right here.
Shove it.
Listen, I do the soft sell. Merle does the hard. So how about paying up before she takes you apart piece by piece? You won't regret it.
And who's going to protect you when the beater gets back?
What's going on?
Guess.
Yeah, you wouldn't have to be too bright, would you? Mugger Maxwell strikes again.
I think they're being nasty about us, Vicky.
Yeah, we're going to be real nice to them, weren't we?
Yeah, sure.
We were. Where would you get protection for the price we're asking? I'm not kidding. Kath will go broke if she doesn't up the price.
Yeah, well, Kath will be broken into little pieces when Rita finds out about it.
Ooh, don't make me nervous or the price will go up.
Do what you like, because I'm not paying.
Mo, tell Lexie what Captain Marvelous does to cheats.
Oh, boy, he's terrific. He really zaps them.
Good for him. And would you do the same?
Oh, yeah, because I'm in the Captain Marvelous Club and I've got a placky badge and everything.
Well, far be it from me to discourage initiative. Now, what's the going
rate? What are you doing?
Half a dozen cigarettes or cash.
Okay, pay up.
Not bloody likely.
Then there's no telling what might happen. Could be very dangerous.
Now,
pay.
It's a dozen to you.
You said six.
You're buying for two.
Screw.
I told you not to leave your cell till I got back.
Oh, I was with her, Mr. Adams.
She has to have an officer with her when she's with the other women.
No big deal.
Yeah, Lex, it'll look real bad for him if anything happened to you. Have a bit of consideration.
Really flies when you're having fun.
always maintained that there's nothing like a man's company to give things the festive air. You must be in great demand for parties, Mr. Adams.
Oh, come on, let's get out of here. I'm going back to my dorm, all right?
I'll escort you.
Oh, you're such a dear old-fashioned thing, Mr. Adams.
Move.
What a creep he is. Ferguson was a creep, but she had her uses.
What really gets up my nose is that Maxwell's doing all right. I mean, a few more days and she's going to have this place sewn up.
Mm.
What's that supposed to mean?
I'm just thinking.
Okay, well, bugger that. Let's just put her out of action.
What was that, Patterson?
Oh, Mr. Adams, we were just wondering what a young man like you would be doing in a place like this. What were you calling him, Lexie?
Oh, yeah. We figure you must be a real action man.
Yes, well, you leave yourself without me again and you'll see more action than you can handle.
Oh, he's a wildly possessive
jerk. Wish it was that simple to get rid of Maxwell.
You are forgetting about Merle.
Oh, you keep saying that. Bugger Merle.
That's like saying that the beauty shouldn't worry about the beast. Listen, little mother. Merle can push you around this playpen like a ping pong ball. Now, we don't push it, we'd be good little girls and pay our protection money.
Yeah, with my cigarettes. If I just had the run of the place for a few hours.
There's got to be another way.
Like what?
Don't rush me. Vicky will be a pushover. We can forget about her.
Yeah, well, the rest ate Maxwell's guts. How about we just gang up?
An operation like this, we're going to need Rita. No Rita, no support. And for the moment, we can forget about her. It all comes back to Merle. Without her, Kath's out of business.
All right, what do we do about her?
Of course, it's obvious.
What?
What an idiot I am.
Yeah, I know that, but what's the idea?
I've been looking at it the wrong way. This is going to work like a charm.
What?
We're going to need some help. But I'm sure we can get him to cooperate.
Who?
Mervyn.
What the hell's he gonna do?
You'll see.
48, 49, 50. Now, you can put all these in the cool room. Where are the girls?
Mopping the dining room floor.
Should have finished that hours ago. Keep away from that casserole.
And Mr. Pringle...
I'll be back in a minute. This seems to happen every day. Cigarettes.
Smells lovely. What's it like? Not much. He wouldn't put any hot sauce in it. Well, good cooks never do things like that. Here, let me see.
I want you to put all these trays together. Tanya!
Well, what have I done now?
There won't be anything left for tea the way you're going.
But it wasn't me.
Thank you, Miss Stout. I'm surprised you used the spoon. It was the fingers before.
Well, actually, she wasn't... No,
fill all the salt shakers. And then you can eat all the salt you want. Look, I'm sorry about that.
Oh, it's lovely. Doesn't need any hot sauce at all.
It wasn't getting any. Now, you wanted to see me?
It's nothing official. It's just... Well, you know the trainee postings come out tomorrow.
And Joyce was talking about it last night.
Was she? Did she say anything? I mean, has she heard anything?
Like what?
Well, like any rumours if we made it or not.
She wouldn't have heard anything like that. But if you'd like... If you'd like me to ask... You're not worried about it, are you?
Me? Oh, no, I was just wondering, that's all.
Look, I don't mind you eating that, but, would you like something with it? Jam or something?
What? Oh, no, thank you.
Right, now come along, you can put all these... Not again. They haven't put these desserts away.
I'll do it if you like.
No, thank you, we can manage, thank you. Oh, dear.
Okay, all done. It's all right, Merle.
Now get out there and start selling. 5 cigarettes for a dollar.
Come on. You're pushing it too far, too fast. They're not going to come at a buck for 5 fags.
Just do it.
Listen, I'm going to need some backup on this. Those chicks are going to kick up when I start selling their own buy-up back
to them. If you need backup, we've got it.
Terrific. And what about when Rita gets back? What then?
Leave that to me.
Like hell. You haven't even thought of anything yet, have you?
I will.
When? Gee, she's not up there for a summer holiday. You know she's going to be out and she's going to spread us all over the walls.
She'll need every woman in the place to do that.
Look, don't count on me to go up against the top dog, okay? I want to live out here.
Where is everyone?
It seems I'm not very popular with Rita.
So?
Well, if you're not popular with Rita in this place, you're not popular with anyone. When's she getting out of solitary?
I'm not sure. Why?
Mr. Adams... I have a favour to ask of you.
This note, you want to get to Connors. What's it about?
A deal. She seems to have a vendetta against me.
Why?
Well, I don't know. Perhaps she thinks I want to be top dog.
Do you?
Do you really think that would interest me?
No, but what interests me is what I'm going to make out of this.
Let's just say our friendship could be mutually advantageous.
Okay,
I want to know about the boat trip. What happened? Everything?
Agreed.
And the note up to Connors?
Well, I thought Merle might hide it in Rita's food.
She's not on kitchen duty.
She could be.
I'll arrange it.
Another reporter. What are you telling them?
Nothing.
If I told them the truth, can you imagine how they'd report it? Wentworth officer goes joyriding with prisoners.
Who is now missing, possibly dead.
Precisely. At least Nancy McCormack insists that Joan was last seen heading off for help.
Oh, I hope she makes it. God help any passive nature lovers who come across her.
I'm worried about Marty and Delia. This won't look good on their records.
You know, I never thought I'd say this, but if Joan walked in here right now, I'd run the flag up and cheer.
Oh, excuse me, I was about to knock.
What is it?
I wanted to see Mrs. Morris. We need another hand in the kitchen, and I thought I'd roster Merle Jones on, if that's all right.
Yes, that's fine.
Right. Oh, excuse me. Any news about Miss Ferguson?
Not yet. Thank you, Mr. Adams.
He's really wallowing in it, isn't he?
Trouble is, on paper, he looks like the golden-haired boy.
Oh, if only the department could find out what he was really like.
They have. My report states that, in my opinion, Mr. Adams is not good officer material.
For all the good it'll do.
There you go.
There you go.
Oh, come on, Ronnie.
All yours for a few fags.
Lavatory paper we can steal for ourselves.
I've got printer's ink, three colours.
All right, we'll trade that for cigarettes.
It's a package deal, six.
Pay up.
Right.
There you go.
1 minute you're paying out fags for nothing, next thing you're getting them for nothing. I can't keep up with it.
Yeah, neither can we. Listen, we are losing badly on this. Oh, think of the long-term investment.
Can you use this?
Oh, certainly.
Yeah? Yeah. Well, what are you going to do with all this stuff? I'm having a tip.
Shovel.
Next.
Perfect.
What's going on?
Oh, just a come little on, bit of private enterprise.
That doesn't answer my question.
Well, that's because it's none of your business.
Yet. But I'm so curious.
Ah, oh,
Kitty.
I've been looking for you. Oh, look at all the pretty paper.
I could ask Merle to get to the bottom
through,
of this.
Merle. What? You the career this woman? Betsy and I have already paid a full week's protection money. If anything happened to us, everyone would lose trust. That'd be very bad for business, funny, wouldn't it?
Come on.
See you. See you.
Bye, Merle.
All right. What are we going to do with this pile of junk?
Create.
Oh, Laurie.
All you have to do is pour this in the meals that are going to solitary.
Why?
To make them feel bad for being against us.
They'll do it?
It should put them in the infirmary for a couple of days.
But Nancy, she's not against us, is she?
It won't hurt her, Merle. But you have to make sure you put it in all three meals, understand?
I guess so. I'm not stupid.
No, I know you're not stupid. But you have to do it without being seen, just like Captain Marvelous.
Ah, Captain Marvelous.
Now, you don't let anyone see you. Anyone.
Jones, report to the kitchen.
Rightio. Marvelous!
Don't run! Are you sure she's right for the job?
It's only a note.
Just seems so unfair. I mean, you study, you do your best and really, really care about the job and everything still goes wrong. Just...
Stinks. No, thanks.
Can you imagine how reports are going to read?
Yep. We went out with one ship, a skipper, four prisoners and an officer, and we came back with nothing.
Don't remind me.
Our only chance is that the Board of Examiners mightn't believe it.
What do you think you do? I mean, will you go back to the Navy?
What do you think? They get wind of my last assignment, they wouldn't put me to sea in a paddle boat. What about you?
Oh, I suppose I could always enter a convent.
You two are having a long break. If you're not careful, you'll have unpunctuality added to your reports as well.
Oh, as well as what? You never miss a chance to sink the boot in, do you?
It's not that at all. I'm just saying what everyone thinks. Neither of you have made the grade.
And you have.
We'll know tomorrow when our reports are issued. Mrs. Reynolds is very concerned.
What about?
Joan.
What do you mean?
Joan can look after herself.
Then where is she? If you ask me, she's at the bottom of the bay or a cliff. Mrs. Reynolds thinks so too.
How do you know that?
She told me. I mean, Joan wouldn't have much chance against Connors and Jenkins after you two deserted her.
Hey, Del!
What's the temper?
You want me to put it in the freezer?
What do you think? Merle!
Yeah?
Never mind. Tanya, you can get the meals for solitary.
I'll get them.
He said me. Oh, where are the forks?
Out there.
that time.
Aren't you ready?
Yes, but look, you can have these. Tanya, come along. Trade duty for isolation.
Radio. Hang on, these are for solitary.
Not anymore, they're not. Now come along, move.
Hey, hey.
What is it?
Aren't they going to the pound?
What difference does it make? Now come along, cutlery, Merle, cutlery.
I'm glad you're the one who's got to tell him.
Wait at the gates. I want some information.
I'm a real bad choice for information. You get sort of cut off from things up here.
Tell me about Joan Ferguson.
Well, she's about mid-40s. She looks like a truck driver in drag.
What happened to her?
We told the governor everything.
I want the truth.
Did Randall send you up here?
No.
Will you let her and the cops worry about Ferguson? It's got nothing to do with you.
If Joan Ferguson's dead, it'll be on my conscience as much as yours.
Only if I killed her.
It was planned from the start, wasn't it? I thought the whole thing was a damn mess, but it was a plan. Delia going overboard, me going after her.
You can't prove that.
To hell with proving it. I just want to know. Delia and I busted our guts to get you work experience and you just rubbed our faces in it.
That's not true.
Isn't it? Well, our reports are out tomorrow, Connors.
Look.
Nah.
It wasn't. Mr. Jackson, I left Ferguson alive. And I hope she comes back.
What are you doing?
Helping?
You're not on kitchen duty.
Profiteroles, perfect.
For what?
For Mel's surprise party. And you are going to make some, aren't you?
What? Profiteroles? Well, what about my budget? And for that matter, what about Merle?
What about her?
Well, all the trouble she caused. Between her and fellows, it's like trying to cook in the Blitz. I had them rostered off.
Oh, I wondered why she looked so dejected.
She did. Well, I'm afraid there's nothing I can do about that.
Even though we're trying to make her happy.
Wilkinson, what are you doing in here?
Oh, well, we're just doing some PR, Mr. Ace.
Out. Now.
Thanks anyway, Mr. Pringle.
I had to do it. They took the wrong tray. I'm real sorry, Kath.
You tried hard, Merle.
Mervyn hates me now, and I'll let you down.
No, you haven't. Now, are you sure you weren't reported?
Nah, Miss Stout, she thought it was an accident. She's not very bright.
And you couldn't get to the solitary food?
There weren't time. I had to stop the other staff going to isolation. I couldn't get their mum sick, could I?
No, no, you couldn't.
You should have seen me. Wham! I was real fast, like Superman. I saved the day.
Yes, you were very clever.
There's nothing more I can tell you. Your mother is quite well. There's nothing I can do about that.
Who's that?
Nancy McCormack's son. He wants to see her.
Which paper? Oh, Mr. McCormack, that paper, I wouldn't take it at all seriously. Well, I don't see that that serves any purpose. Now, if you...
I take it Mr. McCormack isn't too happy.
Well, we'll find out in about 20 minutes. He's on his way here.
I'm not surprised. If he read that article you showed me, he must be worried sick.
He did. He quoted it word for word.
Will he be able to see McCormack?
No, not while she's in solitary. And for her own peace of mind, I'd rather she didn't know he was coming.
Well, do you think it'll disturb her?
Yes, they're extremely close. It'd just make it more difficult for her if she knew he were here.
Yes, I'm sure of it.
You better warn the rest of the officers, Meg. He could cause trouble.
Right, but don't worry. I'll be here when he arrives.
Yes, well, kid gloves. With all the publicity, he's got reason to be concerned.
Well, so is his mother, if Joan isn't found alive.
How'd it go?
Not too well.
But didn't you tell them this would get rid of Maxwell
yes,
for good?
Yes, I told them, but they still weren't too keen to hand anything over.
Oh, the lousy stink of bitches!
You can hardly blame them. They've paid a 4 weeks' protection money. They've hardly got anything left.
Oh,
we're just going to have to work extra hard with the decorations. This soiree's not going to be remembered for its food.
Yeah, well, here's my bit.
Oh, how inspired.
You'll love it.
This is from Mr. Pringle.
Oh, what is it?
Oh!
Woo! Custard pies and jam tarts.
He said to tell you they were cheaper than profiteroles and just as gooey.
Oh, the angel, he relented.
Good old Mr. Pierre. What'd they taste like? Well, how would I know?
And Mrs. Reynolds doesn't mind us having the party.
Oh, just the opposite. She thinks it's a wonderful idea.
Oh, that's great, isn't it, Lexie?
Yeah, great.
And I'm invited too. I'm taking over from Mr. Adams as your escort.
Woo! Now there's a break. I mean, it's no fun raging with Roddy, eh?
There for Merle's party.
Don't you mean Maxwell's farewell?
Lexie, you put that down.
No.
Up against the wall. I have some news for you.
Well, what about?
Your son.
Peter, what's happened to him?
He's coming to the prison.
Oh, I can see him.
I'm not sure. They're not going to tell you he's coming, but I thought you should know.
Oh, thank you. Please, please let me see him. I just want to explain. He won't know what to think.
I might be able to arrange it, if only you'd just cooperate.
Well, what do I have to do?
Just tell me what really happened to Joan Ferguson.
But it is just as I told Mrs. Reynolds. When I last saw Miss Ferguson, she was alive and going for help, and that is the truth. Now, please, can I see Peter?
I believe you should. He's very upset, you know.
Why won't they let me see him?
I've told you. Look, I might be able to help there. Might.
But I've told you all I know, honestly.
It's not enough. You know more, and you need to see your son. Help me, and I'll help you.
Oh, that's ridiculous. I mean, I can understand the papers not giving out any names.
It's Meg here.
Don't worry, darling. If there's anything the matter, they would have told you by now.
I'm beginning to wonder if they know themselves.
Right, thanks. Mr. McCormick, I do sympathise with your position, but do try and understand mine.
I don't give a stuff about your position.
Yeah,
all I want to know...
The lady's only trying
Danny, just keep out of this, OK?
Assistant.
Sweetheart, I know what I'm doing, OK?
Is the governor with you? Well, if you do see her, will you get her to call me at reception? Yes, thanks. I'm sorry, that's all I can do for you, Mr. McCormick.
Oh, well,
now,
that's
if you'd
not
just
good
like
enough.
To take a seat.
I've got a right to know whether
now,
or not
my... the governor now. Mrs. Reynolds, this is Peter McCormick.
Yeah, I'm Peter McCormick. I'm told you're the only person here who can tell me anything about my mother.
She's fine, Mr. McCormick. As a matter of fact, I was just coming
I'd like to see her, please.
I'm afraid that's not possible at the moment.
Why not?
She's in solitary confinement until we can find out exactly what happened. I can only reassure you that she is well and I'll be in touch as soon as she's allowed to have visitors.
Now, I'm sick of this. If I don't hear from you by tonight... I'll be talking to every radio and television station in town about this. Come on, Danielle.
Mr. McCormack.
Sorry, look, I'll try and talk to him.
Get me the minister. I'll take it in my office.
Rita.
Yeah?
I hate this place.
Well, I don't know. You get 3 squares a day and a roof over your head. I hate it too.
You know, of all the mistakes I ever made, the one that upsets me most was something I did to Peter when he was a little boy. I'd made some scones and I put them on the kitchen table to cool while I went outside to hang up some washing. Well, he asked if he could have one and I said no, he'd have to wait. When I came back inside later, there were 2 missing. Well, he swore he didn't take them. I didn't believe him and I sent him to his room and I told him he'd have to stay there as a punishment until he told the truth. He broke his heart. He'd been in there nearly all day when I discovered it was his father who'd eaten the scones.
Kids don't remember things like that.
Oh, they do, you know. He reminded me of it the night of his 18th birthday. He said he'd always admired me for the way I had the courage to go to him and admit I'd been in the wrong in punishing him. I wonder what he'd think if he saw me today. What do you mean?
This is the second time in a row he's been here to visit me, and I've been in solitary.
How do you know that?
Mr. Adams told me.
A rotten little bastard! Hasn't he got any feelings at all?
Only for himself, apparently. You know, he told me, he'd arranged me to see Peter if I told him the truth about what happened to Miss Ferguson.
Hey! I want to see the governor! Screw!
Dreamers are lovely. Now, here's two more balloons I managed to scrounge. Would you believe of all people to spring
And how are the parcels going? Oh, aren't they dear little parcels?
Here's two more ribbons that I borrowed from Lexie's board. I knew she wouldn't mind.
Would you like some help there, Angela?
You know, this is very sweet of you to offer your daughter for a party like this.
Yeah, well, Merle's all right. She's just knocking around with the wrong crowd.
I think it could do with a bit of a dance.
Plastic tags and singers, courtesy of the catering company.
With a little help from Mr. Pringle.
Yeah, he's not a bad old sticker. Merle is going to be beside herself.
Oh, bugger, there won't be any room in here for us. Is that a fat joke?
I?
Serves you right. Come on, girls, keep yourself nice. I am going to get the guest of honour.
You've done an excellent job, ladies.
Bloody hell, where'd you get them ribbons?
Look, the other way. Look out behind you. No! I told you. Oh, duck! Bullseye.
Girl, I was wondering if you could help me.
How?
Well, you know, Gran, that's my mum, sent me this lovely jar of sweets, and I can't get the lid off, and you're the only person that I know who's strong enough to take the lid off for me.
Okay.
No, it's not here. It's back in the dorm with Lexie.
Oh. Can't wait till later. This is my favourite show.
Well, I was going to say thank you by giving you one of the sweets, but I'll give you two if you come with me now.
Oh, what are you in such a hurry for?
Well, it's Lexie. She really wants one. You know, it's a craving because of the baby.
All right, but you don't have to give me two, unless you wanna.
Oh, that's very kind of you, Merle.
What'd you say Lexie had because of the baby?
A craving.
What's a craving?
Oh, come on, just one. Just that runny-looking one on the ear. No one will miss it.
No.
But I'm eating for two.
And I'm giving orders for one. No.
Quick, they're coming. Okay, quiet down, everybody.
And then she topped it off with anchovies, chili sauce, and whipped cream.
Yuck!
The frightening thing was that when I was pregnant with Zoe, I craved for exactly that.
Oh, how could you?
Well, here we are.
Surprise!
Merle, it's your party. And we've got presents and food and balloons, and you're the guest of honour.
But why?
Well, some of us haven't been very kind to you lately, and this is our way of saying that we're sorry.
No one's ever done it.
Here, Merle, here's your card.
Oh, we've got presents for you to open too.
This is great. We've done it.
Lexie?
Oh, Lexie.
For she's a jolly good fellow, for she's a jolly good fellow, for she's a jolly good fellow.
You wanted to see me?
Yes, I wanted to see you. Nancy McCormack didn't do anything wrong out on that boat, and I don't reckon it's fair that her son wasn't allowed to see her.
How did you know her son had been asking for a visit?
That mongrel trainee Adams tried to do a deal with her. Said that if she told him what happened out on that boat, he'd see to it that she got her visit.
You'd better be able to back that up with some... Anne Reynolds. Immediately. With due respect, I'd like that authorization in writing, please. Thank you. I'll follow this up with Mr. Adams. Wait outside at the security gates for Mrs. Morris.
What about Nancy's visit?
Come along, Connors.
Bloody hell, you lot stick together like hares on a bloody horse blanket.
That was the minister. He's authorised Peter McCormack's visit.
On what grounds?
Joan's been found.
Oh.
She's alive. It's Anne Reynolds of Wentworth Detention Centre calling. May I speak to Peter McCormack, please? Thank you. Search and rescue have dropped a local bushwalker in to guide her to a spot where the chopper can land, then they're dropping her off back here. At least now we might have a chance of finding out what the hell happened on that bloody boat.
Oh, wow! Look! That makes 8 colours that I've got now. Thanks, Angie. That's a real beauty. Look, did you see the spaceman that Lexie drew in me?
No, not so loud.
Come on, let's keep it down, ladies.
Yes, it's very special. I think you should all be very proud of yourselves.
Oh, these are great.
Yeah.
Would you like one, Miss Stout? I'm sure no one would mind.
Come on. Well, perhaps just one.
You know, I've got to hand it to you, Laurie. This was a great idea. I mean, she's wrapped.
Yeah. Makes you wonder why we didn't think of it a long time ago, doesn't it?
Yeah. Does it better.
Hey, Laurie, look, did you see the 2 pencils that Angie gave me? That makes 8 different colours.
Wow, not so loud.
Oh, sorry. It makes 8 different colours that I've got now. Aren't you lucky? And look, look at that little dog. I didn't see him before, Lex. What's his name?
Pocker.
Oh, he's a lovely thing. Hey, Kath, they're giving Jones and some sort of bloody party.
Who?
Oh, bloody heard them. They're in Angie's cell now, and Jones is as happy as a pickage. Hey, hang on. There's a screw in there with them.
Who?
Stout. Well, what are we going to do?
I don't know yet. Just let me think.
You've been allowed a visit with your son, McCormick, but on one condition, that you don't mention the boat incident. Now, is that clear?
Yes. I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris, you caught me unawares. I had no idea that Rita would be
Connors
able to...
Connors had absolutely nothing to do with it.
You can't believe how nervous I am.
Oh, don't be silly. She'll love you.
Oh, Mum! No physical contact, please.
Oh... It's so good to see you.
It's so good to see you too. Oh, honey, this is my mother, Nancy. Mum, I'd like you to meet Danielle, your new daughter-in-law.
I'm really pleased to meet you, Mrs. McCormick.
Call me Nancy, please. Well, you always were one for surprises, weren't you?
There's more. Tell her, Peter.
Oh, one at a time. I want to make sure you're all right first.
No, I'm fine.
No after effects.
Sweetheart, we're not allowed to talk about that,
honey,
remember?
I'm just trying to find out if Mum's okay.
No, I really am all right, I assure you. Well, what's the other surprise?
Something you've always wanted. You're going to be a grandmother.
Well, I still reckon she's got a chance of springing us.
Not if you keep your head.
Yeah, well, even if she doesn't, these other bitches are going to tear us apart.
Look, by the time they realise what we're up to, they'll have to go through Merle to get to us.
No, she's not here. Can I take
Rodney,
a message?
Could I see you for a moment, please?
Right, how do you spell that?
What can I do for you, Mrs. Reynolds?
I've been told you offered Nancy McCormack visiting rights in exchange for information. Is that true?
Hardly. I can't authorise that sort of thing.
No, but some prisoners wouldn't know that.
May I ask you...
Is it true?
It most certainly is not, Mrs. Reynolds.
I don't believe you. You're very lucky. I've got no proof. Now, come into the staff room.
Any news on Miss Ferguson yet?
She's been found unharmed. That's why I'm here. She's on her way back by helicopter now. If either of you see Delia before I do, would you let her know, please?
Will do.
Certainly, Mrs. Reynolds. Glad I'm not in your shoes. If you and Delia hadn't pushed this work experience rubbish, none of this would have happened. Neither of you's going to be flavour of the month when she gets back.
Okay, come on, Laurie. Movie. And a book. Get on with it. Three words. Three syllables. First syllable.
I can't say it. Oh, yeah, what was that?
What are they doing out there?
Dog.
His name's Poco, and I got all these presents, and I got this from Angie, and I got this one from Laurie, and I got all
sorts of... Oh, Patterson, why'd you have to get that? Oh, come on! Oh, you've just got to hit him, mate!
What the hell is going on? Well?
Please, can I go to the toilet, Miss Stout?
Is it anyone going to say anything?
Please, can I go now?
Go on.
Can I go to her?
Get this cleaned up now! Move!
Come on out and let's talk about it, eh?
I won't talk to no one.
Well, you're going to have to talk to somebody sometime, so come on, sit up and dry your eyes.
I don't want
to. You'll feel better after we've talked about it. Now, come on. That's better.
I want to die in there. I have me presents and everything. You know, that was such a good time.
Because the baddies, Merle. Real, real baddies, and they'll do it again if you let them. So I want you to promise me something.
Oh, God.
I want you to promise me that you won't ever go off with any of the women again unless you talk to me first, okay? And if I'm not around, you just don't go, all right? Promise me.
I promise.
Now, how about you go and get yourself cleaned up, okay? Those two are.
I wonder how she's coping.
I'm more worried about how we're going to cope next time we see her. We're just going to have to keep ourselves scarce.
Wilkins and Patterson, more work and less chatter.
Finished, Miss Stout.
Wait over there. I've got a few words to say when everyone's finished.
He did.
He did?
Mom. I thought the minister was going to drop him.
I reckon you make up half these stories just to embarrass me.
Oh. I do not. Oh, I wish I could have been there.
If... Look, I've still got Peter's old christening gown. It was a present from my grandmother. You're very welcome to it, if you'd like it.
Thank you. We'd like that very much.
Are you making sure she's eating properly?
Oh, I don't have to. She never stops.
Oh, it really has been terrible. I've been stuffing myself.
No, you keep that up. It's very good for both of you. I put on a stone and a half with Peter. Any cravings yet?
Green olives and peanut butter sandwiches by the truckload.
Oh, don't get me started.
You little piglet.
You know, it makes me very happy to see both of you so much in love. And I just wish that I could do more than give you my blessing.
That's more than enough.
So, how many children are you going to have?
Six. Two.
Oh.
Wait! Hey, is that you, Nance?
Quiet, Connors.
Yeah.
Hi, Nance. Where'd they take you, Nance?
Oh, Rita, I'm so excited. They let me see Peter. And he's married and they're going to have a baby.
You're kidding.
No. And Danielle's such a lovely girl.
Wait, hey, but that doesn't make sense.
Pardon?
Well, you're not allowed visitors when you're up in the pound. The Screws didn't say anything.
Well, only that we weren't allowed to talk about anything that happened on the boat.
Something's going on.
All right. So we got a bit of muscle, big deal. But that's not going to be enough if they all come after us together. And it's a dead set certainty they're going to the minute Connors gets out of the pound.
Aren't you forgetting our friend, Miss Ferguson? If Connors has killed her, every screw in the place is going to be on her back 24 hours a day. And that's assuming she isn't transferred straight out of here.
Jeez, Kath, even without her, we're still behind the eight ball. You can't go bleeding these Sheilas dry and expect them to just cop it sweet. Bloody near blew up in our faces just now.
The point is, it didn't. And while we're still on top, they have got to keep paying.
Yeah, but for how bloody long? The only person who can make any decent dough out of a dump like this is a bench screw or the top dog. I mean, all we'll ever be able to do is snaffle a few lousy bucks here and there whenever Connors is stupid enough to get herself stuck in the pound.
I see your point.
You do?
So clearly, in fact, I'm amazed I haven't seen it before.
I don't get you.
If I want to make money in here, and believe me, I do, then I'll have to become top dog.
I know they couldn't have possibly meant it maliciously. They've all been so sweet to her before it started. I guess that's why I got so damned angry seeing something so special ruined by a bit of silliness that got out of hand.
Do you think I should speak to them?
No, not really. Especially after what I just had to say to them all.
Good for you. And thanks for letting me know. It's the sort of feedback I like to get.
Thanks for the news about Miss Ferguson. You don't know how much better that's made me feel.
Delia, it's usually only the better officers who care enough to let it get to them. Just don't let it get to you too much.
Thank you.
Any problems with McCormack's visit?
None whatsoever. I don't think the minister need worry further.
Ah, oh, that I needed to hear. I don't...
The rose is here.